Hello, and welcome to another video in our series of Microsoft Office 365 technical support modules. In this video, I'll show you how to troubleshoot mobile devices that cannot connect to Exchange Online using Exchange ActiveSync in Office 365. This video is intended for administrators of Office 365. If you are an end user of Office 365 and not an administrator, refer to the video at the following location. This video does not apply to BlackBerry devices. Please contact BlackBerry support directly if you are having issues with BlackBerry Business Cloud services. Issues connecting to ActiveSync can occur for many reasons. These include, but are not limited to, the following. The mobile device cannot connect to the internet. For this scenario, the user must contact their mobile network operator for support. The mobile device is configured incorrectly. Refer to the mobile phone setup wizard at the following URL for more information about configuring the mobile device for use with Office 365. The Exchange mailbox server that supports the connection is not available because of maintenance. Sign into the Microsoft Office 365 portal as an administrator and access the service health page at the following URL to confirm Exchange Online availability. The Auto Discover service makes it easy to configure some mobile devices. The Auto Discover service utilizes a user's email address and password to automatically configure their email profile. You can run the ActiveSync Auto Discover test in Microsoft Remote Connectivity Analyzer, also known as RCA for short, to troubleshoot issues with mobile device connection to ActiveSync. Have the user access RCA at the following URL. Click the Office 365 tab. Under Microsoft Exchange ActiveSync Connectivity Test, select Exchange ActiveSync Auto Discover. Click Next. Have the user enter their Office 365 sign-in credentials. Add a checkmark next to Ignore Trust for SSL. Add a checkmark next to the Account Management and Security Disclaimer. Enter the verification code. Click Perform Test. If the test passes, you should be able to configure the device. Refer to the Mobile Phone Setup Wizard at the following URL for more information about configuring the mobile device for use with Office 365. If the test fails, confirm that the AutoDiscover service is configured correctly. Refer to the following article for additional information about configuring AutoDiscover. Microsoft recommends using AutoDiscover when configuring mobile devices. However, mobile devices can be configured without using AutoDiscover. First, the user must determine the server name for their mailbox. To do this, have the user sign into the Outlook web app for Office 365 at the following location. Once signed in, have the user click Options. Click See All Options. Click Settings for POP, IMAP, and SMTP Access. Find the server name that is listed under External Setting or Internal Setting if the server name is in the following format. The user's Exchange ActiveSync server name should be similar to what is displayed on the screen. Now, have the user configure their mobile device using the Mobile Phone Setup Wizard at the following URL. Now we will perform some actions to troubleshoot the issue using Exchange Control Panel in the Microsoft Office 365 portal. First, we will confirm that ActiveSync is enabled for the user. Sign into the Microsoft Office 365 portal as an administrator. Click Admin from the top of the page. Click Manage under the Exchange Online section of the page. Click Users and Groups from the left navigation pane. From the mailboxes list, select the display name of the user experiencing the issue. Click Details. Scroll to the bottom and click Phone and Voice Features. Note that the user's Exchange ActiveSync is enabled. If ActiveSync is disabled for the user, click Exchange ActiveSync and then click Enable. Click Edit. Note the user's Exchange ActiveSync policy displayed on the page. We will later check this policy to ensure the user's mobile device is supported. This page also displays the mobile devices for which ActiveSync access has been granted. Click Cancel and click Cancel again. Now we will check the ActiveSync device policies to ensure the mobile device supports policy settings. Click Phone and Voice from the left navigation pane. Click ActiveSync device policy from the top of the page. Select the user's ActiveSync device policy noted earlier in this video. Click Details. Carefully review the policy settings and ensure the user's mobile device is supported by the policy settings and vice versa. If the policy is set up in a way that the user's mobile device isn't allowed to connect, for example, if the policy requires encryption on the mobile device but the user's mobile device doesn't support encryption, then add a check mark next to allow devices that don't fully support these policies to synchronize. This will ensure connectivity with mobile devices that don't fully support ActiveSync. Click Save if you have made changes to the policy. Have the user try to connect again using ActiveSync on their mobile device. Now we will check the ActiveSync access settings to ensure the device is not blocked or quarantined. Click ActiveSync access from the top of the page. Ensure the device is allowed under the Exchange ActiveSync access settings section of the page. Check the Device Access Rules section of the page for items with the device access rule of blocked or quarantined. If the device access rule is set to blocked, try temporarily removing the rule to see if it resolves the issues. Write down the configuration of the rule to ensure that you can reinstate it if removing the rule does not resolve the issue. Have the user try to connect again using ActiveSync on their mobile device. If the device access rule is set to quarantined, the mobile device will be listed in the Quarantine Devices section of the page. You can then select the mobile device and click Allow to enable the mobile device to connect to ActiveSync. Have the user try to connect again using ActiveSync on their mobile device after clicking Allow for a quarantined mobile device. These Exchange Online settings confirm the mobile device should be able to connect to ActiveSync. Contact Office 365 support if the mobile device still does not connect to ActiveSync after following the steps in this video. In this video, we looked at how to troubleshoot mobile devices that cannot connect to Exchange Online using Exchange ActiveSync in Office 365. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope that you found it helpful.